Everybody, it's Melissa with Melissa's Creations. I know it's been a long, long time since I've been able to post a video, and I miss you guys so much. My life has taken a very, very busy turn, and I am now currently at a full-time job, as well as trying to do a little bit of stamping on my free time. So I did Stamping Saturday today over on my Facebook channel, and I wanted to upload a video here for you guys because I miss you and I just don't get to do as many videos as I used to. So I hope you enjoy this video, and if I get the chance to do any more, I will definitely post them, but it might be a little while. So hopefully you can join me over on Facebook to get your Melissa's Creations fix, and if not, I will try to, as I said, post a few more videos here and there as I'm able. Thank you guys so much for all of your support, and I miss you, and hopefully you enjoy this video. I'll see you soon. Bye, guys! Hey everybody, it's Melissa from Melissa's Creations, and I am finally back for Stamping Saturday. I am so excited. This is the first Stamping Saturday that I've done since my husband and I went to Virginia, and that was in January. So I don't even remember the last one that I did. I think it was last year sometime. So I'm super excited to get started today and do a Stamping Saturday with all of you lovely, lovely people. So we have two awesome cards to do today from the brand new Eastern Palace Designer pack bundle thing. It's gonna be awesome. I can't wait. So yay, I'm so excited. Have any of you had a chance to get a sneak peek at some of the brand new Eastern Palace suite products yet? I am so excited to share two cards with you guys this morning. All right, so the first card, I found my ideas from Pinterest, and I kind of stepped it up a notch. So the original idea for this first card was to just do a window so you could see through it, but I stepped that card up a notch and I turned mine into a shaker card window so you can still see through the card, but it's a shaker card. I have some sequins in there that shake around. So this is from Eastern Palace. I'm going to switch this around so you can see it right way for a minute, and then I'm going to switch it back around again as soon as I get ready to do the cards. Hi, Cindy. Thanks for joining. Oh, I'm so excited. We have so many awesome people joining us today. So this is one of the cards we're going to make today. Like I said, it's a see-through shaker card. And if you're in my VIP group, this is one of our challenge cards that we're doing. So you have a sneak peek in how to make one for our challenge. So this is using the Eastern Palace Suites Designer Series paper back here, as well as the brand new Eastern Palace Suites stickers. These are gold foil stickers. So much fun. You'll see it better in a second when I turn you guys around. And then I have embossed the little hello right here. You can see that. So that is our first card of the day, and it's a little bit more involved, so I'm doing it first so that I can jump right into the harder one and end on a little bit of an easier note. So this morning I was on YouTube and I was looking for some ideas, and Robin from My Pink Stamper did a card similar to this. I think she used the new fig color that we have. I used the Tranquil Tide and Dapper Denim colors, and I love this medallion that you can cut out. Oh my goodness, it's so pretty. So this one is very, very quick and simple. So we're going to end with that card. So here is our first card. It's a shaker card, so you can see those little sequins moving in there. But what I love about it is it's see-through. So much fun. So you could stamp a little sentiment right here, and you'd be able to see it through the front. So very fun, and can't wait to get started. So the materials I'm using for that, if I don't drop them all on my floor first. All right, so I have the Layering Circles Framelits dies. These are two of the circles from that set. And if you don't own this set, and if it's not sold out, I'm not sure if it's on the retiring list. I'm so awful. I'll have to let you guys know if it's on the retiring list or not. But these are amazing. And so I have two of the circles from that set, as well as
a circle from the Stitched Shapes Framelits dies. That's, I think that's the largest circle out of that set. So we're using those three on this card today. And I'm using the brand new Eastern Beauty stamp set. You can get this in a bundle, pre-ordered. Basically, it's an advanced offering for you guys. And with the two different bundle options, you get a free gift with purchase. More about that in a minute. Hi, sister. Thanks for joining, Maria. Okay. So, I also have a piece of window sheet. I have two pieces of our thick, our brand new thick, very vanilla cardstock. I'm so excited to use these. And these are really nice thick pieces too, just like our regular cardstock. And then I have a couple of sheets of the Fresh Fig, which is a brand new ink color for this year. This is a sneak peek at some of the brand new products in the new catalog, you guys. So this is Fresh Fig, and I've cut a card base out of one, and I have some scrap of the other so that we can do our little circle here as well as our hello sentiment right there. So the first thing I did was I scored my cardstock in half, and I'm just going to use my bone folder to give it a nice crease to get that ready to build on. And then we're going to do a little bit of stamping. So the first piece I'm going to stamp is going to be on, hi Sim, thanks for joining. I'm so excited, we have such a great crowd today. Oh yay, you guys are awesome, making my morning. All right, I'm using the brand new in color Tranquil Tide along with this fun feathery type stamp from the Eastern Beauty stamp set. It's this one right here. Look at how gorgeous these stamps are, you guys. I'm so excited to play. I haven't been able to stamp in such a long time, so this weekend is all about getting my craft on. I have a lot of things to catch up on, so I'm really excited. Okay, so I'm going to make my own border for the inside of my card. So what I'm going to do is ink this up with my Tranquil Tide, and I'm going to start by stamping down in the lower left corner. Hi, Glenna. Thanks for joining. Oh my goodness, we have such a good crowd. If you're just now joining us and I haven't given you a shout out, make sure you leave me a comment so that I can see you. If you're not on my friends list, I don't know if you've joined or not. So if you're kind of new to me, go ahead and leave me a comment and I'd love to give you guys a shout out. So I did one in each corner, and now I'm going to do one right in the middle, right there. And you can leave it as that, or you can add a little more. You could change colors, really a lot of different options, but I just liked how it looked when I put a couple more in between like that. I thought that looked so fun. So we're just going to do a little bit of stamping there, and then I'm going to add just a little bit to the edge just to make it kind of a finished look and make it look like it's just going right off the page, which it is. So there. So that is the border, the custom made border for my card. So I can put my Tranquil Tide ink away now. I'm going to set that aside so it can dry a little bit before I glue it to the inside of my card like that. Okay, so now we're going to do some big shot work, and I'm going to grab that out and we'll cut up a couple of our pieces. Oh, I think, oh, that's what it was. I was like, this morning when I was prepping, I'm like, I don't think I have everything ready. What am I missing? And I could not for the life of me figure it out. I'm like, why am I missing a piece of this for my card? Well, I only need one of these for my card. The other piece is some of the designer series paper from the Eastern Palace suite. So I'm going to stick this extra back in, and I'm going to pull out the piece that I need for my DSP background, which is this side. And you're going to get to see me cut that up. So sometimes it's so hard cutting into this beautiful paper, but it must be done. So here we go. So for the piece on the outside, I cut mine to measure 4 by 5 1/4. So I'm going to cut a piece off at 4. Actually, I'm going to do 5 and a... How long is this? This is 8. Yeah, I'm going to cut it at 5 and a quarter so that I can get 2 4-inch pieces out of it in case I want to do more cards like this. So, 5 and a quarter, and now at 4. Okay, so that's the piece that I was missing. I'm like, oh my goodness, what am I doing? It's too early, and I've only had 2 cups of coffee. I definitely need to make another pot. I'm pretty sure it's coffee o'clock right now. Okay, so let me grab my Big Shot. Oh, and I have brand new plates. I am so excited about these brand new plates, you guys. So here's the difference. This is a brand new plate. You can see how shiny and clear it is. And this is an old plate. Yeah, you can see the difference. It still functions just fine, but sometimes, you know, you just gotta break up the new plates. That's all there is to it. All right, so there's a lot of Big Shot work on this card. So I will try to make it not confusing. Hopefully I don't mess up. We'll see what happens. There's a good chance that I will ruin this card on my first try since I haven't had too much coffee yet. Okay, so step number one is to take the smaller of the 2 regular circle framelits, and we're going to cut one out, and I'm going to try and place this kind of in the middle here, but up towards the top here. I'm trying to make sure that there's equal amount of space on those 3 sides. So I'm going to cut that out right there. So put my plate on top, run that through. Okay, so there's the first piece. Grab that out. Okay, so this is the piece that we want to keep for our card, and then this piece you can put in your scrap bin so that you can use it on another project. All right, next up, I want to cut into my card front. So I'm cutting on this side here. So I'm going to, I know it's kind of hard to see, but I'm having to kind of do my videos a little differently because I don't have the same mechanism that I used to have to film with. So you're getting more of a close-up instead of farther away. And I'm limited on my space on my desk, so bear with me. Okay, so I want the same size circle cutout on my fig paper that I have on here. So what I'm going to do is just lay this down where I will be putting it when I get it glued on, but I'm just not going to glue it on yet. I'm going to use a sticky note to hold everything in place. And it's okay if it goes off, it's just going to crumple up a little bit. It's not a big deal. So that's just kind of like my tape, my temporary adhesive for right now. So I'm going to put my thinlit back onto my project where I want that to cut out of the purple. So I'm going to cut that, run that through. There we go. And then that should have cut out a circle from my purple piece, like so. So this, again, in our scrap pile. And now I have my cutout here, which should, when this gets glued on top, it should be right in position, perfect position. Hi, Mary Jo. Thank you so much for joining. So glad to see you. Okay, so there is the first couple of pieces, and now I need to cut out my little purple ring. So I'm going to bring in a scrap piece of that fig paper, and let's see, I need these 2. So this is one of my stitched circle framelits, so I'm going to put that onto my fig paper, and then I have the largest circle regular framelit. So I'm going to go ahead and I think I have to do one of them at a time. Let's try that one first. Actually, it cuts out the whole thing, doesn't it? So I need the small one. I don't even think I used the large one. Yeah, this is right. Sorry, guys. Okay, so the smaller of the two circles that I have out, plus the large stitched shape circle. And then I'm just going to kind of layer them like this, because all I really want to get out of this is a little border. So gently lay those down and run that through. And I'm kind of doing a, it's almost like a porthole. So when we get those taken off, that's what I am left with, this fun little ring. Okay, so I think, oh, we have just a couple more things to cut, and that's the largest one. All right, I'm on track now. So here's my window sheet, and I'm using the largest circle framelit, and I'm gonna cut two out of this. So we'll run that through. And I didn't cut in advance. Oh, do you hear that? That's perfectly normal. It's just, this is such a thin material, this window sheet, that it really goes right through and right onto that plate. So there's my first circle. And now I'm going to cut one more. And I didn't cut these in advance because I wanted you guys to kind of see which circles I used for what. And I'll try and explain it a little bit better if it's not clear. So let me know if you need some more explanation. Okay. So there's my second window sheet circle. Now I think we're ready to go. Let me set all of my framelits aside here and put these scraps away and get this out of the way. Okay. Yay! So excited. So let's see if I can remember how I got this all together on my first card. I made my sample card, I think it was yesterday. It was either yesterday, no, it was on Thursday that I made it. So it's been a day or two. All right. So what we have are two window sheets. We have our little circle guy, and then we have our designer series paper. So I'm going to set this aside for now. We're going to work with this one first. So basically one of those circles goes over this hole on the wrong side of your designer series paper. And for the adhesive, I am going to, I want to make sure that it sticks right away. So I'm going to use Snail right now. But if you had some time to let this dry, I would use the fine tip liquid glue and just do a small bead around that hole and then put your window sheet on. But since I'm a little bit pressed for time, I'm just going to go around it with a little bit of Snail, which will also work just fine. Because we are going to put some more adhesive on this and kind of pop it up in a minute. So whichever way is just fine. So I'm going to put my window sheet on there. Okay, and you can kind of see you have quite a bit of room. There's about anywhere between a quarter of an inch to about, I don't know, a little bit less all the way around. So it's just fine. So there's our window. Now I am going to do my stickers. Yay, here's some stickers. So these are the Eastern Gold vinyl stickers. They do come in the Eastern Palace Suite bundles that you can choose to purchase early before the new catalog launches on June. When does it launch? June 1st? Doesn't say, does it? I have a copy here, but I don't think it says on the front. Pretty sure it's June 1st. I'm so awful, aren't I? All right, so I'm going to use these fun foil stickers here, as well as this one here. So I'm going to take this off first. And these are so great. They are literally stickers. You just peel them right off and stick them right down. So kind of get your placement. And they are fairly easy to get back up from the window sheet. If you stick it down and it's not quite in the right position, you can carefully peel those back off. All right, so now I'm going to do this guy. Try to get him as centered as possible. I am in and out, so if I do not respond to your... Okay, thank you, Cheryl. And then the middle sticker here. I love these stickers. They add so much fun to this project without being too
cumbersome. All right. There we go.
Okay, look at how fun. Instant medallion. Gold foil medallion on that window. Yay, love it. All right, so now I'm going to use some of that fine tip liquid glue to put on my little frame for my circle here. So I'm just going to squeeze a little bit, and this stuff is super strong, but you do need to let it dry for a little bit. So, but I wanted to get my stickers on before I put that on. And make sure that you always replace the lid right away when you're done using it. You've heard me say that time and time again. You don't want it to get dry, otherwise it will not function for you very well. All right, so I'm just going to get that right on there and let that dry for a minute. So while that's drying real quick, I'm going to bring in my card base again. And my insert that I stamped, the border, we're going to put that on the inside with some snail, just like so. Love it. All right. So now we're going to start making the magic for our shaker card. So it's a see-through shaker card, right? So you can see on the inside, it's nice and clean. I don't have anything glued to the inside. So I'm going to take my second window sheet I cut out, and I'm going to glue it right down to the front here. So again, you can either use the fine tip glue, or you can just take a little bit of snail and run that along the edges. And you can do this opened or closed. You know, probably open if you're worried about getting adhesive on the inside of this part, but that's good for me. See, just like that. And then we'll just put that, kind of center that over again, glue that down. All right, so for your shaker bits, I am using the sequins that I have left over from my Cupcakes and Carousels embellishments kit. This is from the Occasions catalog. And again, since we're so close to the end of the catalog, I'm not sure what pieces are still available and what have already retired or sold out, but that's what I'm using. And if they're still available, you can check those out, or you can ask me and I can check for you after the video is over. So I'm just gonna use up the rest of my sequins. I'm just gonna put them in a pile right down there, right in the middle of this. And I'm going to finish the shaker portion in a second, but I'm getting those ready. So now I've given this a little bit of time to dry. It probably should dry a little bit longer, but for the sake of the video, I'm going to go ahead and go for it anyway. So on the back side, I'm taking my foam adhesive strips. And I'm just going to peel one of those off. And it'll use a couple. So I'm going to put it around the perimeter of the card, all the way around the outside edge. And this part doesn't really matter. You don't have to, like, be perfect. I'm just using it so that I can, pop up my card and have it be nice and sturdy, as opposed to using a couple of dimensionals here and there. I like the strip all the way around. Okay, so grab another strip, finish that off. And again, it doesn't have to touch, it doesn't have to be precise. This is just strictly to pop up the card. Okay, there we go. And now I'm gonna take one final strip. This part is a little bit more important. So what I'm going to do is go around that circle, making sure that I don't go past the designer paper, because I don't want to be able to see this adhesive through the shaker part. Does that make sense? So I'm going to go all the way around, and one strip should do a complete circle. A tad bit left over. Now this part you do want to make sure it joins because you're going to put your sequins in there and they're going to shake about. You don't want to lose them. All right. So now with that done, before I peel this off, I'm going to bring in my embossing buddy. This is going to help with the static so that the sequins don't stick to the edge of the adhesive in here. So I'm just going to kind of run my embossing buddy around that edge just so that it loses some of that adhesive. And then I'm going to, you know what? I don't even have tissues in here. I'm going to take my shirt and I'm just going to kind of polish that window sheet so there's no fingerprints or anything. I would definitely use a tissue for this, but I don't have one in this room. So now I can take off that adhesive backing on all these pieces. And one more. I love these foam adhesive strips. They are some of my favorites. Okay, so now I'm going to bring back in my card, and I have my sequins down there. So now I'm going to sandwich this right on top. Try and make sure it's all centered. And then seal that down. Just give it a nice press all the way around your edges. Okay. And there we go. Look at, oh, I love it. Yay. See how lovely those sequins shake around in there? A lot easier. On this card, I did not do the embossing buddy. You can see these guys, they're stuck on the edges of, because that's where it was still sticky. So using that embossing buddy really, really does help. It helps a lot to get those guys to move around and not get stuck. Okay, one more step on this card and then we will be done. So make sure everybody grab your catalogs. Make sure they're handy. We're going to play some games in a minute. If you don't have paper copies, you can go to melissascreations.com, click on Shop Now, and you can download a copy of the catalog to play along with us. So, there it is. Yay! Okay, so the last piece to this beautiful, beautiful card is to do the little sentiment that goes here, and we will be embossing that with gold embossing powder. So let me grab my scissors, and this part does not have to be precise at all. I'm just going to snip a little scrap, and if you already have scraps, perfect. These are the best things to use up those scraps on. So again, I'm going to bring in my kind of embossing kit. So I have my embossing buddy that I'm going to use so that I get the static off of my paper and my embossing powder only sticks to the VersaMark stamp and not anything else. So now I'm going to bring in my VersaMark, and I have mounted my little hello sentiment, and that is from the Eastern Beauty stamp set. This one right here up in the corner. So we're going to stamp that little guy kind of off to the left a little bit over here. And then grab out our gold embossing powder. And we don't sell these trays anymore, but you can definitely just use a piece of paper folded in half. That works just fine. I just so happened to have this from years and years ago when Stampin' Up! Offered it. I decided to snag one, and I'm glad I did because I do use it all the time. All right, so now I need to unplug my phone and plug in my heat tool. Okay, so this is the Stampin' Up! Heat tool. It has two different settings on it, a low and a high, and it has a kickstand so that if you use it a lot and it gets warm, you can set it on the kickstand and not worry about hurting your surface. So it's going to be a little bit loud for a minute while I heat this gun up a little bit so that I can emboss my beautiful hello sentiment. Let's hopefully you'll be able to see it change in a second here. Here it goes. Yay! Gorgeous! All right. So now I'm done with that. Okay. So I'm going to take my paper snips. And I don't have the punch, but if you did, there's a punch that makes a banner edge, kind of, a reverse banner edge. I'm not sure what it's called, a pennant? I'm not sure. So I don't have that, so I'm just going to do a couple of snips from there to there to kind of get that edge on it. And then I'm going to take some of those leftover pieces that I used from my foam adhesive strips, and I'm just going to put those along here so that they pop up. I use every little bit of my dimensionals and my adhesive strips, guys. Every piece. No matter how small it is, I can find a use for it. All right, so I'm going to peel that off. Bring in my card, and then this guy is just gonna go right there. Just a quick little hello, and then I'm just going to trim off the excess in line with that paper, and there it is. Isn't that fun? We have a see-through shaker card. Oh, using some of the brand new Easter Palace Designer Series paper and other products from that
suite. Here comes our next card for Stamping Saturday. And again, just a reminder, I'm only doing the morning session. I will not be doing an afternoon session. So, here is our next card. And this one is super quick and simple. I didn't put an insert inside, although I probably would recommend it so that you can write on here and see it a little easier. But yes, very quick, very easy, but so pretty with the brand new Eastern Medallions Thinlets dies. These are so cute. Now, I have a couple that are missing. I have them that, excuse me, that we're going to use in just a minute. So here they are. This is one side. There are so many dies in here. And we have these on this side that coordinate with the Eastern Beauty stamp set. So again, these come in a bundle. You can get a bundle with almost all of these products in it. And I'll tell you how to do that in just a minute. So Mary Jo, the colors on this one. So the colors are a couple of brand new colors. We have the Tranquil Tide, which is one of the brand new 1618. No. Which one? The brand new in colors, but it's not 1618. I think it's 1719. So 2017 to 2019 in colors. This is Tranquil Tide, which is what this color is for our card base. And then we have Dapper Denim, which is a 2016-2018 in color. So those are the two colors that are on this card. And those are the colors in this Designer Series paper as well. And then it's very vanilla is the base in here and this piece here. And like I said, this card's going to go super, super quick because there's really not much to it, but it's still so beautiful. Okay, let's start by stamping. I have a piece of thick, very vanilla cardstock, which you can get for free. That's right, you can get it for free in one of the Eastern Palace Suite bundles, which I'll tell you about in a minute. So, first of all, I have my stamp already mounted. This says, "To think of you is to smile." Again, from the Eastern Palace, the Eastern Beauty stamp set. So there's this cute, cute one, Let's Be Friends Forever. But I'm using this one, To Think of You is to Smile. And there are a lot of really cute sentiments in here. Enjoy today. Also a thank you. I love a set that always includes a thank you because it coordinates with the artwork and it's just so useful. So Tranquil Tide, ink that up and we'll stamp that right up here.
We're going to cut that out on the Big Shot. So we're going to do a little bit more Big Shot work. So I'm going to bring that guy back in. Quick is my style, Janet says. Absolutely. Sometimes you just need quick, real quick. And this is one of those cards that you can do that with. All right, Big Shot again. We're going to cut out To Think of You is to Smile. We're going to cut our sentiment out with one of the smaller stitched shapes, stitched circle framelit. So we're just going to pop that on there. Yeah, Facebook is being weird. I know you guys, some of you can't see her comments. I can't see any of Cheryl's comments, but I know she said she was in and out, so I'm not sure if she's still hanging out or if she's just being quiet. Okay, so isn't that gorgeous? I love these stitched shapes. They add so much character to a piece without adding anything. In fact, it's not even really doing, it's not adding or taking away. It's just, you know what I mean? I mean, it's just so simple. I love it. Okay, so that's all on that piece. So I can put that into my scrap bin. All right, so now the other pieces I have. This is from the Eastern Medallions Framelits or Thinlets dies. Isn't that gorgeous? Oh, I love it. But we're adding a scallop circle from the Layering Circles Framelits dies. So basically, we're going to be cutting it out like this to create our medallion. And I'm going to do that with a piece of Dapper Denim cardstock. This is cut at 4 by 5 1/4. So I'm going to set that down. And I'm using this piece as my mat for my card as well as to cut out. So I love getting double use out of my paper. Why waste? There's no need to waste your paper at all. Okay, so carefully put that down without it moving around too much. There we go. And then run that through. Okay. And, oh, I'm so excited to show you guys. This is so pretty. So it just pops right out. And I think actually that's all the cutting on here we're going to do. So I can set this aside now. All right. So it just popped right out of the middle there. And then you just pop out these extra little bits. And if you have the dye brush, you can use that paper piercer. Although you can see how easily they're coming out just with a little bit of assisting from my fingers. So they just pop right out. Like that, and that is what you have. Oh my goodness, isn't it gorgeous? So you can also use this die without cutting the circle. So if you were to do that, you would just get, it would just cut that right out of the paper if you did not use the scallop circle, and it would just be there and it would be on your paper and it would just be so pretty. But I like the cutout because I'm going to put it onto the front of my card with some Designer Series paper. Okay, so here we go. Are you guys ready for how quickly this card goes together? So once you have your pieces cut, it's literally boom, boom, boom. Okay, so here we go. Card base, bone folder, score, snail, mat. Oops, I have my hair in there. Come on, get out of there. I should time myself, but I'm not. All right, first mat down, designer paper. Look at the other side. Isn't that purple gorgeous? It's that new fig. Love it. Boom, done. Bring in the dimensionals. Slap a couple on the back of your circle. Peel that off. Put that in the middle of your medallion. Turn that over. Boom, boom, boom. A couple more dimensionals. It's like less than a minute after all of your pieces are cut. Less than a minute. Probably less than 30 seconds. I haven't been timing myself, but here we go. And boom. We are done. Oh my gosh. Wasn't that the fastest card I have ever, ever done on a Stamping Saturday, you guys? Seriously. I love it. Love how fast it goes. And it's still so cute. Hi, Patty. Thanks for joining. We just finished. This card was so fast. It was like lightning fast.
Oh my gosh, you guys. That was awesome. Thank you so much for joining me. I had such a good time. And I think I will miss doing an afternoon session. But like I said, I'm working now. I have a full-time job, 40 hours a week. Well, it was basically 45 hours last week. The last few weeks, it's been a little bit more. I've been really busy, but I'm finally getting to a point where I can get back into my crafting. I'm not giving it up by any means. It's just, it's taking me a while to get back from Virginia and finish unpacking our house from when we moved before we went to Virginia for 2 months. And then unpacking from Virginia, and then just getting life back in order when we got home, and then getting a new job. And I have a couple of other DS businesses, so getting those, you know, off the ground and running and everything. It's just been so busy, but in my heart, I am just so excited to be here and do this again. I've missed it so much, and I've missed you guys, and I've missed interacting with you. So thank you so much for making my first Stamping Saturday back and getting back into the swing of things so much fun. Janet says, been fun. Glad to have you back. One session is good, especially in the spring. Yes, I agree. I think that's probably good. And on the Pacific Coast, you know, it's still a little early. It's 11 o'clock right now. So 1 hour is about the time I expected this to take. That's what it's usually taken. So it's been actually pretty good. I went ahead and flipped you guys around because I want to show you the flyer for the Eastern Palace Suite. So these are the products that I used today. You are already eligible to order these, you guys. These are brand new from the new catalog. This is only from May 1st to the 31st that these specific bundles will be offered. It's like an advanced product offering. You can get, thank you, Reba. I've missed you guys too. You guys are awesome. May 1st to May 31st, you can only get these bundles with all these products in it. After May 31st, you buy them a la carte. You buy them one at a time. Although the stamp set and the framelits, you can still, I think, I'm pretty sure they're offered as a bundle. But all the other items, you have to buy individually. So here are the details. Let me get my other screen up so I can read it along with you guys. You can kind of see it here. And I will post some photos so it'll be a little bit easier to read for you. But basically, there's two different bundle offerings. The first one is the starter bundle. Hopefully you can see that right here. The starter bundle includes the Eastern Beauty stamp set, the Eastern Palace Specialty Designer Series paper, the gold vinyl stickers, lemon lime, tranquil tide, and fresh fig classic Stampin' Pads, plus a pack of very vanilla note cards with envelopes as your free gift. So for all of those items I just listed, those are in the Eastern Palace Starter Bundle. That bundle price is $60.50 in the U.S., and those very vanilla note cards and envelopes are a free gift in this bundle. Write this down. The item number to order the Starter Bundle for this package is 147-196. Again, 147-196. That's for the starter pack for this bundle. So that's the first one. The second one, hopefully I'm holding this where you can see it and it's not too crooked. All right, so the next one is the Premier Bundle, which includes the stamp set, the Designer Series paper, the cardstock pack, the mini tassel assortment, the gold stickers, lemon lime, tranquil tide, fresh fig, classic Stampin' Pads, the Easter medallions, thinlets, and then also the very vanilla medium envelopes along with the very vanilla thick cardstock, those last two items are your free gift in the Premier Bundle. The Premier Bundle is $103.50, and that item number for the Premier Bundle is 147207. So again, that's 147207. And if you use my May Hostess code to order one of those bundles, I will send you a free gift as well. So again, you have those two options. I will post them onto my site, onto my Facebook feed here. So you'll be able to kind of see a little bit better what's in each one. They are some awesome, awesome products. And I think you guys pretty much know from the cards that we made today how many different options you can get out of the materials. I purchased the Premier Bundle and it was awesome. I got all of that stuff. Everything that, all the new stuff that I used today was from that Premier Bundle. So it's a really, really good value. After this bundle goes away, you have to get the items individually, except for the stamp set and the thinlets. I believe those might still be bundled. But you're not going to get those free gifts. The very vanilla note cards and envelopes in the starter bundle is free in this bundle only. And it's only available until May 31st. So jump on it if you like these products. And again, if you use my Hostess code for this month, you'll get a free gift from me. And again, I am a little bit behind on my thank you cards, but I have all weekend to catch up, and those are going to be coming out to you guys very soon. So, oh my goodness, I think that's it for business. if you have any questions about the Eastern Palace Suite, let me know. I'd be more than happy to answer those for you.
Thank you guys so much. I will see you soon.
Take care, everybody. Bye.